Joshua Pacio!
One strawweight world champion, Joshua Pacio. A young phenom of the famed Team Lakay, whose skills and experience reach far beyond his years. Pacio's first experience in a world title bout took place in October 2016. He faced off against dangerous Japanese ground specialist, Yoshitaka Naito. The bout didn't go Pacio's way, but the loss proved to be the best thing for the young athlete. Pacio's maturity as a martial artist grew, and he quickly worked his way back up the strawweight division to a second shot at the world title and a chance for redemption against Naito.
Ready? Choke! Can he take them championship gold here tonight? Michael Chavello, Mitch Chilson with you. It's Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set. This one for the big one. Left hook early from Joshua Pacio in the red and an outside thigh kick from the Filipino. This match brought to you by UC 1000 Lemon Water and Orange Water. Rehydrate and protect.
You can see Joshua Pacio has a little bit lower stance than usual, has his hands a little bit lower, possibly looking to defend the takedown with underhooks and sprawl a bit heavy. He's immediately starting to attack the legs of Naito because I think he saw that Alex Silva was able to exploit the leg kicks within the title match that Naito lost. So he's using a lot of leg kicks because he knows that this might be a weakness for Nobita.
Pacio did say that Naito's striking would be his undoing. And you see Naito trying to get this contest to ground. Good sprawl out there from Pacio. Throws a knee. Nicely done from the Filipino. Bounce back up to his feet, and Angel breaks off. Just got out of the waiver. Bolo scooping up a cut there from Pacio.
Pacio looks extremely relaxed. That was a telegraph takedown. Easy sprawl by Pacio.
Angel went for a low single, Sakuraba style. Good counter there from Pacio. The heavy artillery off the hands. He become the fourth Team Lakay world champion. For Liang, Stuckrio, Benario. The next name, beat Pacio. So fifth, actually, Kevin Bellignon too. Fifth Team Lakay world champion. So many of them. It's incredible success. Bellignon, he will be against Pacio in Singapore in November. There's a great shot from Pacio. He sprawls out. Here come the right hands from the Filipino. The aggression early on from the Pacio.
I think he hurt him with that body kick. You can see him wilt a little bit. Pacio went to the left hook to the body. Now he was attacking the whole body again on the ground.
What a start here from Joshua Pacio.
This match is starting to look a lot like their first encounter.
What was the undoing of Pacio 2 years ago, Mitch?
He made one mistake. He was in there for a takedown, and immediately you could see that Naito jumped on the back, sunk in that rear naked choke. One minor mistake on Pacio's part, and the night's over. But Pacio, he's now attempting to take Naito's back.
He said he'd like to do the passion lock. To do that, he's going to take Nobita's back. He's going to put him in a rear naked choke and then sink in the chicken wing.
Look at the way he's setting up that arm. He gave an instructional video on ONE Championship, on ONEFC.com, or the ONE Super app for this exact move. He's controlling the underside on that arm. He's got the underhook. Now he's going to try to threaten the choke and then pull that arm back.
Is he setting up the passion lock on Naito? That would be incredible. Joshua Pacio, the 22-year-old, dominating here in the first round under mixed martial arts rules, our global rule set for the World Strawweight Championship. Taking his time, thinking it through here, Pacio. Where does Nobita go from here?
Well, he's got to go. He's got to turn into him. He's using the cage. You might want to try to spin around, but he's got one hand controlling on that side. Now you can see him. He's trying to go chest to chest. He does a good job of that, but Pacio sprawls very heavy. Good defense by Pacio. Naito can't reach the legs like that. He's got to set that up a little bit more carefully.
already a lot of reddening on the back of the knees of Naito, courtesy of the leg kicks from Pacio. 50 seconds remaining, first round set for five. Takedown attempt there from Naito. Pacio sprawls out, tries to trap him in a choke attempt here. Naito out of trouble, looks for a head kick on the break off.
Good job by Pacio. He saw that overhand right, he knew that's how Naito likes to enter the takedowns, and he sprawled very heavily. He did it again. He threw that overhand right, goes in for the entry, goes after the legs. Pacio knew it was coming, sprawled heavily, but now he's got his hips up against the cage. Now it's gonna be a little harder for him to sprawl. He's gonna try to take that single leg, but I think he's gonna run out of time.
You get the feeling that Naito might like to try to drag this one to deep water. Naito has been to the fifth round four times in his career. Joshua Pacio has never been beyond three rounds.
Look at Pacio looking nice and relaxed. Ate a bit of a high kick there, but immediately answered back with a nice little hook, straight hook combination. Pacio attacks the body, but I think before that, before he got hurt, he threw a nice kick to the body, and that was initially what did the damage. Lunged in there, caught him with the left hand to the body again, but then when Naito shot in for the legs, you could see Pacio continually attacking the body again. Good first round for the 22-year-old Joshua Pacio.
Big hello to all of our fans watching in the Philippines, cheering on Joshua Pacio on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. And those in Japan on Abima TV, cheering on the champion, Yoshitaka Naito, from inside the sold-out Jakarta Convention Center in Indonesia. Second round, mixed martial arts action for the strawweight championship.
Ready?
Scheduled for five. Pacio in the red. Champion Naito in the navy blue.
Ooh, beautiful time knee right as Naito is coming in. Bingo, hit him with a right knee.
Roundhouse kick to the rib cage there from Pacio. Nobito took some punishment to the legs, and there goes Pacio back to that lead thigh of the champion. Wasn't a great opening round for Nobito. Tries to thread the right hand, sprawls out as Pacio. Locks onto a single leg now does Naito. What can he do from here, Mitch? What are the options?
It's these relentless attacks from Naito. He's consistently attacking after the legs. Joshua's got to be very careful here. He's trying to suck in the leg right here. So you can see him controlling the ankle, the left ankle of Pacio, who's going to try to pull that foot away from Joshua Pacio and put his butt onto the mat just like that. Now he's going to roll up. Joshua's doing a good job of defending here.
All tied up like a pretzel here in the second round. This is what Nobita does so well. Always thinking, always planning, always plotting. The champion. And what's going on there with the leg of Nobita?
Good job by Joshua. You can see he was trying to get sucked in. Nobita was trying to pull the legs in, but Joshua's hips are so heavy he was able to control the position. Now he pushes off. Back to the feet.
Nobita edges forward again, the champion. Right of screen, body shot there from Pacio, going for the bread basket. Goes the head kick on Nobita. Beautifully done from the Pacio. Overhand right, goes for a shot. Good sprawl out again from Pacio. Nice takedown defense. Fake right hand there from Nobita. Very wide stance on the champion. Goes to the body. Sprawl out again from Pacio, doing everything right so far in defense here, Mitch.
That he is doing, because remember, it's just like in the first exchange these two had. It was two rounds. Joshua was stopping the takedowns. Look at this, he's taking the back now, setting up that possible passion lock again.
Mitch, talk us through the passion lock again. What's the mechanics of it? What happens in the passion lock?
Well, what he's doing right now, he's got the back, he's got both hooks in. He controls the underside arm with his underhook. So he has that underhook on the right side of Nobita. Now, he's gonna threaten the choke to get Naito thinking about the choke, but he's really aiming for that hand. Now he doesn't really quite have the wrist yet. Pacio is trying to control the wrist on the right side, but he's also trying to threaten the choke. And that's what he's gonna do. He's gonna pull the arm behind when the when Naito's thinking about the choke, and he's gonna try to kimura it basically into a chicken wing and crank on that shoulder. It's an extremely painful move. He was trying to take the arm completely off Pungsu Mitsati when he locked it in.
He called it the rear naked chicken wing. He dubbed it the passion lock on the night. It's become one of the viral sensations online. So many thousands of fans have watched the passion lock from Joshua Pacio. And he seems to be in control again here in the second round. Nobita, the champion, maybe looking for a way back to his feet. He posts up on the right arm, and Pacio keeping him down.
A few people, Michael, have called it a hammer lock, but I like the passion lock much better.
Right hand transitions into a takedown attempt, and top position now for Pacio. This is some good stuff we're seeing from Joshua Pacio of the Philippines, Mitch.
He is definitely seizing the moment here tonight. But, I mean, these are the things, these are the small little things, these small little mistakes. At any moment, Naito can jump on your back and choke you out. That he does this so well. He lures people into a false sense of security, and right when you think you're fully, you know, you're winning the match, boom, it's over, and you're going to sleep.
Butterfly hooks now from Pacio. 45 seconds remaining, second round of five of this mixed martial arts main event for the strawweight championship of the world. Japan versus the Philippines, Naito and Pacio. Inside the guard of Pacio now. Naito top position. What can he do from here? He drops an elbow across the jawline. Good work from Nobita. Goes to the body with the left hand.
Naito likes to draw people into deep water and then suffocate them. And that's what he's doing right here. You know, he might have lost these first two rounds, but now we're starting to see that championship experience. You know, how many times has he been into the fourth and fifth round? He does his best work in that deep water.
He's been to the fourth and the fifth round, I should say, four times in his career. Here's the ground. Once again,
that was a close second round. You know, a little bit, you know, into the, you can see Naito starting to pour it on, starting to get control of a lot of these grappling exchanges. But man, Pacio is looking sharp. His striking is on point. His takedown defense is looking real good. This kid is rising to the occasion.
Okay, Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. If you're in Nobita's corner, what are you saying to the champion?
I'd like to see him mix it up a little bit more. Right now, he's only throwing that overhand right to a double leg takedown. He's got to try to put a little bit more of a combination together. Throw a 1-2 hook to the body, then go to the legs. He's not really setting these up very well. He can also maybe start catching some of the kicks of Pacio. Catch the kicks driving for the takedown.
Remember, folks, under this mixed martial arts global rule set, we do not score round by round. The bout is judged in its entirety by the three judges here cage side. And what a sight is right. The sold-out Jakarta Convention Center, alive and a-happening. Third round of five in our championship main event.
You can see Naito looks a little bit more aggressive, looks a little bit more agitated.
Beautiful popping right hand to start there from Pacio, sprawls out. Now Pacio on his back trying to execute a choke here.
Nice little takedown there, though. Joshua went down a little bit without much of a fight at all. But this is where Naito really starts to excel. He starts to just grind on his opponents, outworking his opponents on the ground, landing little shots. He controls the hips very well of his opponents, consistently sucking in their hips, controlling their movement.
Top position for the champion, Yoshitaka Naito, the comic book lover from Japan. Lost the title to Alex Silva, won it back in a rematch. This, another rematch from 2 years ago. On that occasion, Naito the victor. Pacio believes he can sink the passion lock on the champ to take the gold back to Baguio City. A very hard ask against the guy as good on the ground as Yoshitaka Naito.
Good job of Pacio to get out of the guard and gets, now he has got these underhooks here. He's able to use them to get out of the position. Good job from Pacio.
Inside leg kick from Pacio. Nicely done to that back leg. Orthodox stance on both men. Naito faking and fainting. Can he get the hands off here? The champion goes in for a double leg. Couldn't execute a takedown. good defense again from Pacio. Locks onto a single, does Naito.
Look at the way he sucked in that leg, Michael. He was able to trap that leg, use his own leg to sweep it underneath, and use that to get Pacio onto the ground.
Although Naito not always successful on his takedown attempts here, Mitch, is he the aggressor, constantly going for the takedowns against Pacio?
Well, we score in two ways, Michael. We score with takedown defense, and we score in takedowns. So if Joshua Pacio is able to stop the takedowns, it's gonna disrupt Naito's scoring. But if Naito consistently hunts for him and he transitions, he chain wrestles, so he's going for multiple takedowns, it's gonna score as well. So they both score, but takedowns score a little bit higher than takedown defense.
We are now halfway through the match, our main event here in Jakarta. Wherever you're watching, in 138 countries around the world, we hope you're loving every moment of this martial arts magnificence. Half guard position now for Joshua Pacio in the red trunks from the Philippines. Can he land some ground and pound? Where does the beta go from here?
Oh, Michael, you missed it though, but in that transition, Pacio was able to use a butterfly sweep to end up on top. So you could see Naito trying to apply pressure from the top position, and Pacio was able to utilize an underhook on the leg, sweep him up over and change the position. But that's the grappling of Naito to get back on top.
You know my mistake, Mitch? I blinked, and these two guys are so damn fast on the ground. You can't even blink. You take your eyes off them for a millisecond, and they're doing something crazy.
Man, let those eyes dry out. You don't want to miss any of this action, because Naito's back on top, doing what he does best, grinding, outworking his opponents.
So what does Pacio do off his back here?
Pacio, he's trying to push off the hips, you know, so he's trying to keep a very active guard. He's not just keeping his guard closed, attempting, you know, to hold on to Naito, waiting for a stand-up. From here, you can see him consistently push. Now he's got the butterfly hooks, and he's gonna try to trap one arm and sweep him to one side, or put the feet on the hips and push away.
Obita has become a master of decision wins. He's got six of them in his career. Now Pacio would like to finish the champion, to claim the gold, to take it back to Baguio City, to inspire the uninspired in the Philippines, just like his heroes, Edward Filaing and Manny Pacquiao. 40 seconds remaining, third round of five. This has been a fantastic contest on the ground.
Pacio's only got two blemishes on his record, and they've come both from Japanese athletes by rear naked choke. So that's been his Achilles heel. And you can see Naito's trying to collapse the legs. He's trying to push the legs down and pass the guard. But Pacio's really shown improvements in his guard, his ability to keep his legs in front of his opponents and keep them wrapped around his body.
Naito can finish you at any moment. When he won the Shooto strawweight title in 2014, he submitted Shinya Murafuji with just 3 seconds remaining in the fifth round. He can lock them on from anywhere at any time, Yoshitaka Naito. We're going to go into the fourth round of five. Now we are getting into that deep water.
So you blinked, Michael, so let's take a look at it here. Look at the guard of Pacio. He's able to control the feet on the hips, and he's looking to get one leg inside. You can see one foot underneath the leg right here. Right here, that left leg, he elevates him up and he sweeps him over. Beautifully done butterfly sweep right there from Pacio. Beautifully done. So we're starting to see the improvements, you know, like we talked about at the beginning of the broadcast, the improvements in the ground game of the passion, Pacio.
Pacio says the loss to Naito 2 years ago in Myanmar humbled him. He considers it a blessing, a huge learning tool. And now he finds himself in the fourth round against the champion in front of a sellout crowd in Jakarta. What a night Conquest of Heroes has been. Two more rounds remaining in our main event.
All right, ready?
Cage ready? Door closes.
Choke!
Here we go, fourth of five, mixed martial arts global rule set. And Pacio comes out with a left hook. Haven't really seen Nobita get his best strikes off tonight, as we did see him last time against Alex Silva in their rematch. Makes a leg kick to Nobita. takes a leg kick from Pacio.
This is uncharted water for Pacio. He's never seen a fourth round. He's never been into the championship rounds. But he's doing a good job so far of stopping this takedown and landing some significant strikes of his own.
How many hours do you think they trained the sprawling of Joshua Pacio in the lead up to this one, Mitch?
You know, Team Lakay has been criticized for years that the grappling game is their Achilles heel, but now we're starting to see some huge improvements from every single one of their athletes on the ground.
One of the powerhouse teams in all of Asia, indeed in the martial arts world, Team Lakay. Look at the champions they boast. Edward Falayan, Jeha Yastukrio, Kevin Bellignon, Honorio Benario, all have held or do hold world titles. That is amazing for the team from Baguio City in the Philippines.
Can you imagine what their walls must look like? Just covered in belts.
Body shot there from Naito, falls short. Body shot from Pacio, fires the uppercut. Outside leg kick. A shade of red on the lead thigh of Yoshitaka Naito. In fact, it's now a kaleidoscope of color. Taking some punishment courtesy of that back shin of Joshua Pacio. Nobita not committing to the roundhouse kick. And again, Pacio finds the mark on the lead quadricep. That leg's got to be hurting Nobita. And that leg damage will make it harder for Nobita to shoot in on Pacio.
You know, he just did right there, and he's able to get that single leg. Beautifully done, little turnaround takedown off the single leg there for Naito. Pacio's trying to hold onto the head, trying to elevate him now. But we're seeing some like superior striking from Pacio earlier.
Okay, Mitch, we're almost midway through the fourth round of five. Let's play coach again. What are you telling Nobita to do right now?
Nobita, he's got to show ground control. He's able to get Pacio down, so he's scoring the takedowns. But B, he's not advancing his position, and that's what shows ground control. You can see he hasn't been able to get past the guard. I might have spoke too soon as he's knifing that knee right through the guard there of Pacio, but Pacio does a beautiful job of maintaining the guard. So he's got to advance his position. He's got to do damage. He's got to show aggression by landing some ground and pound, and he's got to advance his position.
And what would Mark and Team Lakay be telling Joshua Pacio right now with just under 2 minutes remaining in the penultimate round?
Pacio's doing a beautiful job on the ground here. Look at him, he's attempting to go for Kimuras. He's consistently attacking. He's trying to maintain the position, but I think he really wants to get up, just like he did now, but he made a slight mistake. Good little scramble, but he is able to get back up to his feet. Beautiful dive.
Naito wants to put him down again. Oh, look at the elbows on the collarbone there of Naito. And Pacio on his back again. What can the champion do from here? Top position for Yoshitaka Naito.
Nice little transition from Naito, but again, he's not able to get past the guard of Pacio. Now he's into half guard, so now he's going to try to flatten out that arm. There's a possible arm triangle here on that side, but Pacio's got to keep his arm underneath, try to get underneath the head there. That's what he's doing. Good job. But while he's doing that, Naito's taking that leg out.
Mitch, what do you see as the biggest threat for Joshua Pacio?
At the moment, there's not a lot. You know, Naito is not doing a lot as far as ground and pound. You know, he's not able to advance his position, so he can't get past the guard of Pacio. But his biggest mistake, or his biggest possible mistake, is to make one minor error. And that's where Naito really starts to excel and shows that championship medal is by capitalizing on any mistake that you're gonna make.
Inside Pacio's guard, the flurry of ground and pound from Yoshitaka Naito. And Pacio trying to create some distance. Rattles punches to the side of the champion's head. Tries to control his posture. Closes up the guard now. Naito trying to blast his way up. Trying to posture up and land the ground and pound. Ferocious stuff here from the champion. Good work from Naito. Body shots there from Naito and reverse elbows from Pacio. What a way to end this round. We're going to go into the fifth and final. It's the deepest of deep water. It's somewhere Pacio has never been before.
Wow, just at the bell, there was a brief moment where Naito was able to finally get past the guard and end up in mount. I don't know how the judges are going to score that. Look at some of the beautiful work here from Pacio, landed a nice little combination exiting on the hook. But here's Naito on top, trying to work past the guard. And then just at the moment, look at that. He goes out the back door, right? He was about to give up mount. And Pacio was able to get up and stand back up. Good job, Pacio.
Can you believe it? We are going to go into the fifth and final round of the main event here in Jakarta for the World Strawweight Championship. There's the champion, Yoshitaka Naito. Everybody here in Jakarta on the edge of their seats. We've got ourselves a sellout.
Pacio needs to keep this on the feet because we're starting to see the champion start to get his groove, finding the mistakes and advancing his position. Pacio needs to sprawl heavy and let those hands go.
And how about the champion? What does he have to do for the next 5 minutes?
The champion's got to get this to the ground, and he's got to do damage. He's got to do significant damage to Pacio on the ground, maybe on the feet here, but he's got to do something big.
And already you see a little more pepper, a little more mustard out of Yoshitaka Naito. There's a certain gusto about the champion. And now, a high kick from Pacio. Nobita working angles, those awkward angles, the little quarter turns, the little pirouettes. It's the fifth round of our world title main event, Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set in action. Outside leg kick from Pacio. Nobita in center cage. Pacio tried to scoop the right hand. Will the goal go back to Japan? Will it go to the Philippines?
Yeah, we're pretty close either way, but we're starting to see Naito definitely has a little bit more urgency behind a lot of these engagements. You know, he's starting to push forward, and Pacio's slowing down just a little bit. And just as I said that, he lands a big knee. Look at the sacrifice. What he does is he pulls guard into the half guard, and now he's able to get control of the hips. Let's see if he can reverse him.
Top position here for Pacio. Could he find a sub from this position? The 22-year-old from Baguio City in the Philippines goes onto his back here. Top position now for Nobita.
Great reversal there from Naito. He was able to get that single leg, transition out, get back on top. It's a bad spot for Pacio to be in.
So what are the options for the champion here, Mitch?
Well, you can probably wait a little bit. Oh, look at that. Look at it. Beautifully done. Minor mistake. He was trying to pass the half guard into mount. And Pacio is able to slide out, end up on top, and get out.
Nobita wants Pacio on the canvas. There he goes now. Pacio trying to sink some sort of choke attempt. Nobita looking to pass the guard. Goes there. Well done from the champion. What's Nobita looking for here, Mitch?
You can see Joshua's trying to get the legs around one of the legs. So he's trying to catch a leg to get back into half. And that was the battle right there. But Naito looks to be winning it right there on the right leg. Pacio's trying to get back into the half guard, but good job by Naito to nullify that.
Once again, Yoshitaka Naito has been to the fifth round now 5 times in his career. This is very familiar territory. Pacio before tonight had never been past a third round. This is usually where Naito is so strong, where he usually powers up, where he usually owns opponents in the fifth, the final, the championship round.
Good scrambles by Pacio, but I think he gave up the mount. He's back in half guard. Yup, he's back in half guard, but look at the way Naito is able to float around. Almost back in that side control, but good job by Pacio to pull him back into guard to stop the advancing of position from Naito, but he hops over. Now he's back into a possible side control, but a good sweep there from Pacio.
Pacio hunting after the left arm of Nobita. Can he find something here? The passion! The passion! Can he take home that arm? If he takes it home, he'll take home the gold as well. But no, Nobita seems to be okay.
It's going to be really hard. All he can do to use this kimura for is a sweep to control the position.
What to finish?
Naito might try to roll the other way. And he does, and he gets up and continually attacks the leg.
The high IQ of the champion gets him out of that predicament. And now Nobita looking to take it to ground. They go there. What does Pacio do from here, Mitch?
Well, he's trying to push his head away to create a little bit of space and not give up side control. Naito looks to be getting pretty close to it. Yep, now he's got side control. Good advance on the position from Naito. Pacio's gonna scramble though, try to get out, and he does. Attacks the leg.
Back up under their feet. Final minute, fifth and final round. drops down to take the lead from under Pacio. Pacio trying to maintain his vertical base. What a thrilling, gripping final round of action. Indeed, this entire World Championship main event has been extraordinary. 40 seconds on the clock now, Mitch.
Look at that back and forth action from both these guys. Naito is continually trying to pass the guard, but look at Pacio able to keep the guard in place and battle for the last 20 seconds.
20 seconds on the clock. Naito has Pacio's back. What's going to happen here for the champion? Can he sit control for the final seconds? Pacio defends. This one's going to go down to the wire. I'd hate to be a judge. It's so close. It's razor thin. Is he going to finish on top of the champion? Yes, it looks like it. What a contest between two superb martial artists at the height of their powers. My word, that was phenomenal. And look at the respect, and look at the replay.
There was a little bit of a light touch on the leg kick, but Pacio was able to counter with a leg kick of his own. Add a big left hook to punctuate that exchange. Here's Naito continually scrambling, always looking for something, always trying to move forward, has that ground control. Look at this, he's able to end up on top in the exchange, goes after the leg again, and I think he was able to secure the takedown there at the end of that grappling scramble. But man, what back and forth action. I have got to say, I am extremely impressed, win or lose, with Pacio's improvement in the grappling.
The judges must decide. Three judges came side, scoring on an overall bout, not round by round. Will it be Joshua Pacio, the 22-year-old from Baguio City of the Philippines, becoming Team Lakay's fifth world champion, alongside Pabayan, Benario, Galignon? This is incredible. Or does Nobita retain the title? Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new world strawweight world champion, Joshua Pacio!
It's a new world champion! It's a Filipino world champion! Ready? Jump! This one brought to you by sitebeat.com. Chosen with you, Saruta in the black trunks, Pacio the Filipino in the red. Pacio, one of five Filipino world champions in the men's division, Tier 1 championship. They are the dominant country, and he is the youngest world champion. Oh, head kick coming close there from Pacio, and we're on the ground for the first time.
Personal time over here on the ground is going to tell us a lot. Pacio's down guard. Let's see what Saruta can do. If he's just going to choose to soften him up, keep him there, or is he going to try to pass and advance his position with the ground control?
Could Pacio possibly find a way somewhere in this contest to take the back seated on Saruta and employ the passion lock? It is spectacular. It was voted the 2019 Submission of the Year. Saruta, two submissions, five knockouts and 18 victories. Last time out, defeated former world champion Alex Silva by unanimous decision. That was on ONE Championship debut.
It's a methodical approach so far from Saruta. He very quietly punched, stepped over into the half guard. Now he's flagging out Pacio. Pacio needs to try to get to his hips. That's what he's doing. He's trying to move to his side for a little bit of space. He's got to sit on the left side of his body so he can start to angle out and get away. All of Team Lakay is extremely explosive. We like to power out of moves, explode as
their preferred form of escape. Kevin Bellingham is a perfect example of that. Right now, Pacio's got an underhook on the right side, so now he's going to use that to slip even more onto his side.
Pacio, who usually looks for every opportunity to get to his feet and employ his sensational strikes, is keeping it on the ground at the moment. Top position here for Saruta, the Japanese champion. Tries to back in the guillotine there, did Pacio, but no avail.
Good job by Pacio to get almost back to full guard, had a butterfly hook in there, but Saruta was able to step over and get back into half guard now. Again, Pacio's doing all the right things. He's hip escaping, but he moves his hip to the outside, tries to get sit on his left side, so he can start creating space.
Saruta looked to posture up and drop an elbow between the eyes of the champion. Pacio looking for a way back to his feet. Is he going to get there?
Nice job by Pacio to create a little bit of a scramble. Now he's got Saruta pressed up against the cage. Oh, that's the strength of Saruta trying to scoot around.
And now a chance to see the Wushu strike here of one world champion, Joshua Pacio.
Interesting guard from Saruta. See how he angles his hand? Dead arming his arm up by his head, covering his elbow with his face, dropping his left hand down to his side.
A very cagey and tremendously strong customer is the challenger, Yosuke Saruta. This the main event in ONE Championship's first show in 2019. It's Eternal Glory from inside Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia.
I'm not sure I've ever seen that stance before. The players,
leading with that elbow.
Up underneath, throw an Anderson Silva type elbow, or is he trying to throw a reverse hammer fist?
Sticking that elbow would be more the case from the stance he's employing. We aren't seeing those cunning Wushu side kicks from Joshua Pacio that we're used to. Look out, Saruta races back to center cage. There's that strange, awkward stance of his awkward guard of Yosuke Saruta. Under a minute remaining.
Kind of leaves the body open to that right side body kick. Pacio could throw a roundhouse right to the body, but I don't know if he wants to do that because Saruta might catch it and take him down again.
Pacio, the first of Lakay's four world champions to defend in 2019. Next Friday night at the Former Major Arena in Manila, Jay Yoshitaka puts his world title on the line against Brazil's Adriano Moraes. And then March 31st in Tokyo, Edward Falayang puts his strap on the line against Shuga Aoki. High up on the balls of his feet here, the champ, Joshua Pacio.
Final 10 seconds, a takedown here might be perfectly timed for Saruta just to kind of... Nice little leg kick there thrown by Pacio.
A jumping roundhouse kick, must skip up on it there from Joshua Pacio. We go to the towels at the end of one.
That awkward stance shown by Saruta. He throws that head kick, bomb, lands just ever so off the top of the head there as he goes up top to the head. And Saruta was able to get on top, you know, but he wasn't able to really do anything. He wasn't able to advance his position. He got to half guard, but he really wasn't able to do with it. Chose to do a little bit of ground and pound. Pacio was able to work his way back up to the feet. Not much happened in that first round. You know, but it was interesting to see, you know, how Saruta was going to approach the stand-up aspect of it. He kind of did, they used that weird sort of guard. That was the most interesting thing for me.
Both men looking very relaxed as they receive instructions in the corner. The Wajutsu Keshugai Hearts team in the corner of Saruta. Team Lakay, Mark Sanjau in the corner of Joshua Pacio. Second round set for five. Inside Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. The ONE Strawweight World Title. The holder in the red, Joshua Pacio of the Philippines. Saruta would love to put Pacio on his back again. Work some ground and pound. Try to find a submission. Let's see if Pacio can employ some of those side kicks. Let's see if he can pull the trigger on his right hand.
It's almost like Pacio's a bit hesitant to kick. Necessarily want to leave anything open, leave anything for Saruta to grab onto.
Pacio goes for the legs.
Saluta thrusts out the lead hand. Lead hand, as we mentioned in the opening round, is very strangely positioned, forming the guard of the challenger.
Pacio quite hasn't found his range yet. He's trying to just kick to open up the exchanges. Hasn't put a lot of hands yet. There's a nice little takedown. I like how Saluta changes and chain wrestles. He consistently goes for one takedown after another. He's a little bit high up on the body lock here. I see him drop down, change levels, but that overhook on the right side of Pacio is preventing Saluta from really dropping down. Now he might be able to step over.
Twists like a mini tornado knee there from Pacio. He's backed against the cage here. Both men trading knees. Pacio off the left, Saluta off the right leg. Inside knee, trying to cork up that thigh there, Yoshitaka Saluta. Where does Pacio go from here, Mitch?
He's got an overhook on that right side, so he's trying to turn out to the right, but it's hard because Saruta's got an underhook on that side, so it kind of enables him to have a slight advantage. Saluta lets him go again. Shows the exit on the knee. He feels more comfortable out in the middle of the ring, the cage rather, than having him up against the cage.
Saluta leading with that left elbow once more. Jab two from the Japanese. Counter right hand there from the Filipino. A left roundhouse kick from Pacio. Goes to the body, looping punches. A little wild on the execution there, Saluta. Two world champions in the cage. And Saluta the challenger for the ONE world title. Pacio the defending champion in the red. Saluta winning on one championship debut last time out. Many would consider it an upset if he beats Pacio tonight, but there's a lot of pundits out there who think Saluta can do it, thinks he has the necessary tools. High kick from Pacio, and that had some starch behind it.
That high kick is there, but Saluta's not doing a lot to deflect that high kick because of that rear guard that's enabling him not to be able to get his hand up around to block the high kick. His hand has to do a complete 180-degree turn to get his hand up to block his head. He can't block those with his shoulder and his elbow.
You know what would work very well against this guy, Mitch? A good old-fashioned Brazilian kick, aka a question mark kick.
I think it would. Maybe start attacking the legs, go after the leg kicks, and then bop, go up top.
Pacio fakes the kick toward the lead elbow, the lead forearm of Saluta, and then loops it over the top of the left shoulder. Question mark, picking up, nice little digging uppercut there from Pacio.
Nice, scoop underneath, came up, popped the chin up a little bit of Pacio, looking good with the hands so far. Now he's starting to get a little bit more comfortable, letting things go. But Pacio's letting Saluta go first. He's countering off of what Saruta's doing. That could just be because of his forward pressure. Saruta's consistently pushing forward.
What we are seeing at the moment in this world title match is a very close contest. Saluta shoots in for the takedown. They're on the canvas now with 45 seconds left in this round. Some acrobatics there, Saluta back to his feet.
Those acrobatics, though, cost him the position. He tried to jump over the guard, and Pacio was able to escape away. But I think that takedown might have counted because his butt hit, but his back didn't fully hit, so the judges might not have given that takedown.
Outside leg kick from Pacio. Big hello to all of our Filipino fans watching live on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Also our Japanese fans watching live on Abima TV. Big right hand from Saluta. He loaded up with that one. Missed the target, though. Trying to get off first with his punches. The Japanese challenger gets up with a high kick. The headache maker from Pacio.
That was about an inch and a half away from sleeping Saluta. But he came very close to hitting there. His timing's coming close. Nice little exchange there. There's that scooping uppercut that Pacio was able to land here. See, his back doesn't quite hit the ground, so I don't know if the judges are going to allow that to score. You can see there it actually goes, so that might be counted as a takedown. You can see him try to cartwheel over, but that space gives Pacio just enough room to escape out the backside and get back up to his feet.
interesting first couple of rounds. Hard to score those two. You're seeing a lot of counter striking from Pacio, a lot of forward movement and aggression coming from Saruta, but he is applying that pressure, and he did attempt a few takedowns right there, but we're not seeing really the chain wrestling that we saw from Saruta against Alex Silva. We saw him put these takedowns together and not just stop after one. He kept going, two, three takedown attempts, and that was what led him to success against Silva. We're not seeing that here against Pacio.
Two world champions in the cage. Who will emerge with a strawweight gold? And Pacio take it back to the Philippines, and Saruta take it to Japan. Olivia Cost gets us underway. Some damage you saw in the corner under the eye of Pacio. Nothing serious though. Tried to catch Saruta coming in. Saruta didn't commit to any punches. Left hook there from the Japanese. Head movement from Saruta, changing levels. Having these angles here. Jabs his way in, but very open looking jab. Shoots him for a double leg, stops the takedown attempt. Does Pacio, nicely done from the champion. Oh, guillotine attempt from Pacio! What's Pacio got here, Mitch?
He's got a guillotine, but he's in half guard. He doesn't really quite have the angle. You can see how high the head of Saruta is. Pacio's got to create a little bit more, and he's got to get his hips a little bit higher, so he probably doesn't have it. He's going to have to let it go as he can gas out his arms. What I'm most impressed with is the takedown defense of Pacio. Typically, Saruta does a very good turn. He turns the corner very well off the double leg, and Pacio is able to follow him around and stop that takedown. Let's see what he can do here off his back. He's got to dig on that underhook. But you see Saruta's cradling his leg right there. Pacio scrambles back up again. Good job, Pacio.
Let's see if the Filipino Pacio can get his strikes off now. Haven't seen much of the side kicks from Pacio. We're so used to. There's a roundhouse kick to the upper right ribs. Saruta, lead hand, just popped it to the tip of the nose. High kick from Pacio. Only the single strikes, though, from Joshua Pacio. Needs to start some combination work, but he's worried, as Mitch alluded to earlier, that Saruta may catch a kick and drive him to the canvas, take advantage.
These kicks to the left side of the body have been working very well for Saruta. I'd like to see him attack that leg. Just start digging in and start attacking that leg, get Saruta thinking about that leg. And with that guard, boom, head up top, the head kick. Easier said than this position, easier said than my position.
Here's a try for a catch and counter from Pacio.
Pacio seems to be counter-striking. He's waiting for Saruta to go first, and then he's coming back with shots of his own.
Is that a clever game plan from Pacio?
Well, he's scoring. He's landing. I don't know how the judges are seeing this, but he is landing effectively.
Dangerous spin there from Pacio. Left hook misses for Saruta. 2:20 remains in the third round, set for five of our World Championship main event. From Astana Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia, it's Eternal Glory. ONE Championship's first show of 2019. Don't forget, next Friday night, we're at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Jay Hayastuglio in action. Main event, world title defense against Adrian Morales. A planting right hand to the kisser there from Saruta.
Saruta was able to catch that kick, but the footwork of Pacio was very effective. Even on one leg, he was able to maintain his balance and stifle the takedown attempt from Saruta.
Saruta edging forward. Elbow, the left elbow leading the way. It's very unique guard of his.
See, but Pacio sees it too. He sees exactly what we do with that guard. He's going after the head. But Saruta has very good eyes. His reaction time is very quick.
Counter. Catch and counter there from Saruta. Another tactic that Pacio could employ with that lead arm of Saruta so far extended, especially the elbow, Mitch, is good old-fashioned Muay Thai 101. Just kick the crap out of it. Just try and kick the humerus, kick the elbow over and over again, and break that arm down because it's hanging out there like a target awaiting to be struck.
But I think Saruta heard you, and he's starting to hang up a little bit higher.
Let's speak a little softer here, Coach Sack. Inside knee kick attempt there from Saruta. Pacio did really go to town in that lead arm. That forearm, that wrist, cracks and roundhouse kicks. See if Saruta doesn't bring that arm back or drop it completely, leaving him exposed in that left side.
Oh, jump turning back kick!
Pacio in.
Oh, jumping roundhouse kick! He stunned him! And there's the right hand from Pacio! And now the power elbows from the strawweight world champion!
Pacio channeling his inner Kevin Bellignon with that jump turning back kick.
How he changes it up and starts going to the other side of the body. Not just going after the head, not just going after the legs, but the left side of his body, spinning and attacking and going after the center of his body. Good job, Joshua Pacio.
An aggressive end of the round from Pacio Dragon, and the crowd appreciated it here in Jakarta.
Look at that, again, Silva allowed Saruta to go first, countered with a hook of his own. Time shot there from Joshua Pacio. There he is going airborne, attacking the other side of Saruta's body, landing, connected just ever so slightly on that knee, that jumping switch kick through there.
There's something that really worries me, Mitch, about Pacio is he's tending to throw the spinning back fist with more frequency, but he's a little slow on it. And we all know what happened to his teammate Edward Falayan against Martin Nguyen. You can't make the same mistake against Saruta and be a little too slow on the spinning back fist, and Saruta may catch him in that spin around.
Well, the biggest thing, the difference I see between these two is that Martin Nguyen has impeccable timing and footwork. I'm not seeing the same sort of timing and footwork from Saruta, so I don't think Pacio's as worried about it, but he does have a big right hand. Saruta does have power in that right hand, and he has knocked people out before with it.
All right, fighter. We enter what they call the championship round, and fittingly so, as two world champions square off. A charging single leg takedown off the bell from Saruta. House on fire. He's going to up the aggression. He's going to up the mercury.
Pacio went for the hand touch, and Saruta ducked underneath it and shot in for a takedown. I don't know how I feel about that, but you got to protect yourself at all times.
And Saruta top position. Oh, Pacio gets back to his feet. What a start to this penultimate round. The aggressive meter suddenly rises in Saruta's favor.
After a very good third round from Joshua Pacio, Saruta's got to step things up a little bit. Now we're in the championship rounds. Now we're in the rounds that are going to decide this match. And Saruta, he's been in those championship rounds. He's gone a full five before. He knows what this deep water is like.
The takedown there from Saruta. Put on the hips here from Joshua Pacio. Looks at the push off.
I like that. Good push there from Joshua Pacio to create a little bit of space, but not quite enough for him to get back up to his feet.
Saruta looks to pass. Locks onto a single here against Pacio.
Man, it's so hard to hold Joshua Pacio, Pacio down. This is, Saruta was able to hold down and beat on Alex Silva. He's not able to do that to Joshua Pacio. Explosion from Team Lakay.
Joshua Pacio beats a Japanese for the title. He will defend Yoshitaka Naito. And he brings another Japanese warrior here tonight in Yoshitaka Saruta. Five world strawweight title on the line, defending champion Joshua Pacio from the Philippines in the red. Asuka Saruta, the challenger, also a world champion in his own right, in the black. Jab to a attempted takedown there for Saruta.
He's trying to turn the corner. He's trying to angle off to the right and get in there. He's attacking the single leg, trying to change direction. But Pacio's got that figured out. He has his number, and he's able to stop the takedown very effectively. Good cage control shown by Joshua Pacio, but he's got to do a little bit more, especially in this round. The first half of this fourth round looked to be all Saruta, but Pacio's doing a good job of dictating where this match is going.
Cooking right punch off the break there, Yoshitaka Saruta. He dances to it again. Jump turning back kick from Pacio. That one was under the diaphragm. Naruto needs to get in here, and he does. Overhand right, this is the target. Good head movement from Pacio. Under 2 minutes remaining to the fourth.
Rather than trying to turn the corner on Soto's takedown, maybe he might want to just blast right through the double leg. See how he keeps trying to do that knee tap? He's going up on the arm and then coming down with the leg, trying to throw Pacio out to the right. If he just goes through, cradles both legs and dumps him to the left, he might be more successful in his takedown because Pacio has that figured out.
Neither of these world champions are showing signs of fatigue, which we know that Pacio won't tire out of. There's one thing that Team Lakay is renowned for. It's the cardio, it's the gas tank. They can go on for days.
I've been through a conditioning session at Team Lakay, and it is something unreal.
Especially how high up are they? They're at Baghdad City.
Man, they are as high up in the mountains. It's like 4 hours uphill.
Skip inside thigh kick there from Saruta.
Saruta's trying to push forward now. Shadow boxing there just to get Pacio out thinking about the hands. And he's gonna shoot for another takedown here. He's creating that space.
Opens me involved with the hands. So it'll turn the front foot now. Under 40 seconds remaining in this fourth round. Oh, fake downstairs did Pacio. Then wanted to come and clip him over the top of the left hook.
Pacio's trying to time that takedown with a knee right there. Good takedown defense, but Soto's able to clasp his hands. Gotta watch the arm and guillotine now. So we're just choosing to press him up against the cage. Interesting strategy from Saruta. I think he might feel the choke coming on. He gently sets him down.
Final seconds of the fourth round. We're gonna go into the deepest of deep water, the fifth and final in this world title main event. It's just quickly, I did look up the elevation of Baguio City. It's about 4,810 feet above mean sea level, or 1,466 meters, so pretty damn high.
That is some serious elevation. So when these guys, they've lived in that elevation, so that carries over for a long time. But here is the takedowns from Saruta. He was able to get this match to the ground. He was able to do a little bit of damage on the ground, but he's not able to hold Pacio down. Pacio keeps popping back up. This match is pretty close so far. These have been close four rounds. Either round could go either way, Michael.
All right, Mitch, play coach for a moment. First of all, what are you telling Joshua Pacio to do?
Joshua Pacio has got to be more aggressive. I'd like to see him throw his hands more. He's doing very well when he's going first. He starts kicking the other side of the body. If he's going to spin, go to the body. But when he's got to throw those hands, I'd like to end with the leg kicks. Throw the hands, boom, go to the leg kicks. If I'm in Saruta's corner, I want to see him turn the other way on the takedowns. He's got to get this to the ground. Drive in, attack the double leg, sit Pacio down, but then settle down. Ready? Don't try to scramble. Don't try to jump past the guard. He's got to settle down into the takedown, sit on top, and drop bombs on Pacio.
Champion versus champion. Striking versus grappling. Pacio and Saruta, and they open up with the acrobatics, with the heavy artillery. High kick there from Pacio, came close to ripping the shin around the back of the neck. Saruta high on the balls of his feet, the head movement here from the Japanese warrior, goes downstairs to the legs, so too does Pacio. Thought about going upstairs again, Pacio. Chance for up for the Filipino once more here in Indonesia.
Takedowns from Pacio, attempts with defense from Pacio. Digs those underhooks, keeps Saruta up to maintain this match on his feet. Now he's got to go first. Throw those hands, punctuate with the kick.
Big release on left hand there. Number one world champion, Joshua Pacio.
Telegraph takedown from Saruta.
Overhand right, Pacio. The uppercut went so high, I heard organs playing. Saruta resets. Pacio edging forward. This Indonesian crowd has gotten behind the Filipino tonight. Did you expect that?
How can you not love Joshua Pacio? All he talks about is finding your passion, realizing your dreams, supporting the kids, people chasing their goals. How can you not fall in love with this kid? He's 22 and winning world titles.
Amazing young man, Joshua Pacio. Is he 3 minutes and 25 seconds away from retaining his world title. Overhand right.
Nice right landed by Sarutai. He's got to do more of that, but he's got to do something dominant. I think he might be a little bit behind in the scorecards. I don't know if those takedowns are enough. Ooh, now he's trying to be aggressive.
Sarutai swept through off the brow of Pacio. Oh, Pacio tried for a jumping knee, and then backed up against the cage in front of our commentary position.
I told you he was timing those takedowns a little bit. He saw Sarutai coming in. Let's see if Sarutai can take this down.
Booking knees to the thigh here from Saruta. Pacio, wrist control. Saruta getting instruction from his corner. So too, Mark Sanjiao yelling across at Joshua Pacio. Tries to drop down Saruta, advancing right hand, and now backs off halfway through this fifth and final round. Intriguing battle for the ONE Strawweight World Title in Jakarta, Indonesia. Oh, spinning back elbow from Pacio. And came within a whisker's length of connecting.
That was different.
Yeah, that was different.
That was a different type of takedown. Pacio had his number on this, but watch Pacio trying to stand it back up. Oh, but he's in full mount now. But look at him scramble back up to his feet, Joshua Pacio.
The crowd loving it from Joshua Pacio. And now look at the Filipino do, the world champion, who is maybe 1:40 away from retaining the crown.
But Pacio says, I got takedowns too. I can control you on top.
Olivia Gomez keeping an eye on top of the action, making sure the work rate is flowing between these two. Two amazing martial arts, two incredible world champions, peaking in their powers. Careful not to strike the kidney area there, Saruta.
Pacio's got his hand clasped, so he has control of Saruta's hips, but that just shows you how good Saruta is and how heavy his hips is. He's got to try to push down on the head and work his way back up to his feet. He does not want to end the match in this position.
Pulls the legs out as Pacio gets back to his feet now, the Filipino. What's Pacio looking to do here, Dragon?
He was trying to turn the corner, but you see the way Saruta stepped over the leg, so Pacio only hits up the mount. What power, what explosiveness from Joshua Pacio to get back up to his feet.
Tremendous back and forth action from these two world champions. 35 seconds on the clock now. Listen to this crowd. They're cheering for Joshua Pacio in the Philippines.
These are two exceptional scramblers. They are moving so well. They never stay in one position for more than a couple seconds.
Caruso comes forward, throws the right hand as a lead pump. Jab team from Pacio. Gets out of time. Saruta goes high. Then grabs a hold of the legs. Trying to plant Pacio. And he gets it down. Final 10 seconds. A chance for a leg flurry of ground and pound from the Japanese. Goes for the right hand. Pacio raises the leg. A wild flurry on the ground. And that's the end of the fifth and final round.
Wow, that was so close. Each round could go either way. There wasn't a dominant round really from anybody except maybe the third. But we don't judge round by round. We judge a match on its entirety, based on the entire thing. Look at this, constant scrambling. No man was able to hold another man in one position for more than a couple seconds.
Bitch, I cannot call this one. It is so close. All I know is that we saw two phenomenal martial arts world champions at their absolute peak tonight, and they gave us a thriller.
Man, back and forth constantly. What an entertaining 25 minutes of action from start to finish. These guys never got tired, consistently pushing the pace, going after each other. Very interesting matchup. I'm intrigued to find out the winner.
This one brought to you by sidebeat.com. Knockout, a winning website. Who's got it, folks? Wherever you're watching, 138 countries around the world on television. If you're watching on the ONE Super app, all of our American fans watching live for the first time on the Bleacher Report live app. How do you score it? Do you have Pacio retaining or Saruta claiming? Let's figure out how close it was. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match,
Once again, we have Chief Executive Officer for SiteBeat.com, Mark Evans. And now, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the red corner. And judge number three scores this contest for your winner by split decision. And new ONE Strawweight World Champion,
champion Yosuke Tsuruta. This one brought to you by Wholesome Salido. High up on the balls of his feet early, the champion Tsuruta. A wushu striking of Joshua Pacio. Pacio, the former world champion. Tsuruta, the ONE world champion and Shuto world champion. Take care from Tsuruta. Switch your stance between the box and southpaw here.
The low leg kicks of Joshua Pacio. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Tsuruta.
Now Mitch, Tsuruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90 degree angle guard we saw him use last time. Oh, turn it back kick! Smack back in the guts from Joshua Pacio.
Nice spinning back kick from Joshua Pacio. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more of the mind games coming from the ninja. Doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Tsuruta, outside leg kick, overhand right again there from Tsuruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pacio here in Manila.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Tsuruta as he ends up in half.
Pacio receiving instructions from Mark Sanjao in the corner here from Team Lakay. Half guard position for the champion. Controlling the posture here though, Pacio, not allowing Tsuruta to posture up and work that vicious ground and pound that he had. Patience here from Pacio, a stalemate move.
You can see Saruta's got his head wrapped around, or his arm, his left arm wrapped around the neck there. Trying to get past this half-guard position of Joshua Pacio. There's a choke he's got. As long as Joshua Pacio holds the head in that position.
Look for finish.
Under 3 minutes remaining. First round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Chung right on top of the action. If Pacio can win the title back, the wall of Asia Arena will melt down. Their feet inside leg kick here from the champion Tsuruta. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker, did Joshua Pacio.
Joshua Pacio's going head hunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines on a Beamer TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion, doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Tsuruta. Inside the Relive Pacio Arena when they chant Pacio's name. All of Team Lakay's former champions are here. Flying Bellignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Tsuruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still Mitre filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
The big kibosh from Saruta. And Pacio on the canvas, on his back there.
That's the end of the filling out process, I assume.
Saruta's got some confidence flowing now. She tries to mount it.
Pacio's got to keep him tight to get his grip back about it. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pacio back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the Russian style is now with Pacio. And he beat the champion to the strikes.
Well, the first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan to perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks away with that belt.
Looping punches from Pacio. 20 seconds remains, no check there from Saruta. And Saruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Taunting with the right hand there, is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pacio. Pacio, jumping roundhouse kick off the lead leg. But Saruta plants him like a tree earlier on with that big punch.
Joshua had some early success here as he spins and goes right to the body with a beautifully timed, but then Saruta was able to answer right back with that right hand. Boom, right on the button, puts Pacio down. And then he was able to get on top and do a little bit of ground and pound. Joshua did a good job though of keeping Saruta nice and tight, getting his, clearing his head, and then getting right back into the match. Very interesting first round. Or should I say sixth round?
Joshua Pacio looking to reclaim the title that the man left of screen took from him. Instructions from Mark Sanjiao and Edward Falayang in the corner of Pacio. Sold out inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines for ONE Championship Roots of Honor.
Ready.
Turned out in their thousands for this one, the Strawweight World Title. Will it be a Filipino victory? Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pacio. Switching stance, Saruta. AEG veteran. Has all the tricks in the book, and then some that aren't even written in the book. Pacio. Looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
Action!
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pacio. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it, though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pacio.
Getting back this from Saruta, a counter punch from Pacio, accidentally struck the back of the head. Apologies there, good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500 plus media members, the biggest in history. All over the news and Team Lakay athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for ONE Championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love ONE Championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. Falayang saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. Meaning that all of Team Lakay's titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Pacio to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but as soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Pacio spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Pacio a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pacio open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective talent blows on Saruta so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Kaftan followed by a right there by Saruta.
Saruta closes that distance incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pacio seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
Like that strategy employed by Saruta, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pacio is going for that head kick time and time again. And there's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Saruta did last time that confounded Pacio. Oh, overhand right from Saruta, tried for the counter.
Pacio said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time, because you can start to see that Saruta started to time that, started to step to the outside right as Pacio was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pacio's got to be careful with this spinning.
Inside leg kick there from Saruta. Mitch went high on the thigh, but do you think that both men are holding back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down to the gas.
Well, in the second round, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. I don't think Pacio expected Saruta to A, come out in this stance, be this mobile, and I think the Saruta is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pacio, because Pacio said he did not want to wait, he did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds.
Another break off there from Saruta. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pacio. Two rounds down, set for five. Strawweight world title on the line. Saruta versus Pacio from inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
Second round was more of a feeling out process than the first round. We got to see that big right hand from Saruta in the first and a couple of spinning back kicks throughout the course of this match so far coming from Pacio. But what kind of changes are we going to make? I'd like to see Pacio start attacking that lower leg, slow down the movement of Saruta, just start hammering on that calf, which is something he said he wanted to do. Start putting the punches in the face of Saruta. I like how Saruta in the first round was mixing things in with the takedowns. I'd like to see him throw hands, close that distance, and start at least giving Pacio something else to think about besides just the striking. Get into his head a little bit more, throw those takedowns in.
Come here.
Third round of five. Wherever you're watching, in 140 countries around the world, we are majorly enjoying it. It's one championship, Roots of Honor.
Ready.
Kevin Chang had the same concern we did, and he urged the guys to show a little bit more activity in the third round.
Jab from Saruta. Roundhouse kick from Pacio, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab with the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Pacio likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pacio can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yasuke Saruta. Saruta, the current world champion. Pacio, the former world champion. And right there from Pacio.
Saruta is still the owner of the biggest punch so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pacio.
Two punch combination from Pacio. Backs off Saruta.
You can start to see the superficial damage on the lower lead leg of Pacio. It's starting to welt up there from that one kick. They're starting to mix things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there from Pacio to get back to his feet.
Crowd momentarily thought that Pacio had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Saruta, mix in the takedowns, get Pacio thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw, like, so he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand-up.
Pacio fainting. So too Saruta. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Saruta, the cagey one. Pacio tried to counter. Inside leg from Saruta. King jab, no right hand for company though. Turning back in, looking for the liver of Saruta. It's a Team Lakay specialty. The impact, the liver.
Final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. Impact of Vegas North that can close down the entire body. They say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch where you're driving the knuckles up in between the ninth and tenth ribs. But the turning back into the liver will do just as well. Overhand right, the cranium cracker there from Pacio. Just needed a little bit more mustard behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pacio starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is. He's starting to put together those kicks with a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations. He's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning
spinning, though.
In.
That time, Saruta was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. Because the problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it to kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. And also the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these ONE Championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pacio. Saruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
In the third round.
Pacio again bound up and spun on Saruta. Did you expect a little bit more action from Saruta?
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gotten slowed down as the matches went on. But Pacio is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown that Saruta hit at the beginning.
Overhand right there from Pacio. Inside leg goes Saruta. Final second to the third of five. Look, two more rounds to go here in Manila for the ONE Strawweight World Title.
Man, these guys have been in the ring, the circle, for 40 minutes together. They have a really good read on what to expect. And so they know each other very, very well. So don't get caught too much in this slow action. But we're seeing a lot of very technical details starting to inch forward, especially now that we hit the championship rounds again. This is round, essentially, this is going to be round nine between these two. I'd like to see Pacio do more of it, be more active, start throwing those hands, start putting the pressure on Saruta, back him up. I want to see Saruta mix in more takedowns, start throwing a little more heat with the punches, backing Pacio up and then shooting him for those takedowns. Very close match so far.
You see the ice being applied there by former world champion Edward Falaya. 130 martial arts world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Two of them in the circle at the moment. Let's see if there's some more pepper, some more get up and go. Saruta body punches here from Pacio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corking knees into the thighs. Pacio turns the champion.
Saruta placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pacio.
Body shot from Pacio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pacio to stamp himself in center circle here. Cross out the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pacio. Some reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pacio, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pacio. Again, Mitch gets in quick and scores, gets out.
This is the Pacio we expected to see. You want to see those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful stance. Kick there from Saruta. Saruta landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown. But now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
Right counter from Pacio. After a really nice left hook. Saruta, under 3 minutes remains, penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacio. Now all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakay athlete.
Your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout! And new ONE Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio!
Ready?
choke, and all Filipino affair inside the sold out Mall of Age Arena. Michael Chavallo, Mitch Gilson with you. Pacio, a massive 86% finishing rate. Catalan, 50% finishing rate. Riding a six-match winning streak, dating back to September 2016, finishing 3 of 6. Pacio, 8 first-round finishes. 4-1 in his last 5. Pacio, turning back kick to the liver early. It's a Team Lakay specialty. We saw it from Jay Hayustakwio early. Outside way kick from Catalan, locks up. And Pacio turns him around, throws him in the liver, gets a takedown, half-guard position for the passion.
A beautiful takedown, making it look easy as Pacio lands in half-guard. Let's see what Catalan is like on the bottom. We haven't seen him up here a lot. He's usually the one on top dishing out punishment. Now let's see if he can take it as good as he can give it.
Rene Catalan has never competed against a Philippine opponent as a pro. He's a two-time Wushu World Champion, Asian Games Gold Medalist, SEA Games Gold Medalist, Asian Champion. One of the top Wushu exponents of all time. But no chance he is a Wushu on the ground. He only has one submission win in 8 victories. And look at this!
Oh, that was beautiful as he slid into the heel hook. You can see Pacio's trying to attack a toe lock, but it looks like he might want to abandon that idea and go after a... He's actually defending kind of well with that leg. He's not enabling the leg to get put in the position. Now, Catalan's rolling into it. He's got to put a foot on the butt and scoop.
Rene Catalan hoping to take the heel home of Joshua Pacio. Pacio has 7 starts in 14 wins and 5 knockouts. And look at Catalan rolling.
He's rolling, trying to get out, but that's just how fast the game of Catalan has developed. You see how fast he put up that heel hook? That was beautiful.
And here's Pacio's turn. Remember, Pacio came out in the media and said he could finish Rene Catalan in under 15 minutes.
Got to get out of this knee bar attempt here right now. You can see Catalan is getting going after the leg locks. That's a knee bar right there. That's a bit uncomfortable.
Chant goes up inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's a divided chant. This crowd is split down the center. Half of them for Rene Catalan. Half of them for Joshua Pacio. This all-Filipino affair.
Good defense shown by Pacio now. Leg still in a precarious position. He's got to try to get that leg free. Small, heavy. Get back up to his feet.
Pacio's favorite submission to the chokes. He's won 3 matches by rear naked choke. 2 by guillotine choke. And he's beaten a Catalan on his record. He's beaten Robin Catalan by second round TKO back in April 2016. He is undefeated 8-0 against Philippine opponents. Interestingly, all of the losses of Joshua Pacio have come against Japanese opposition as he drops an elbow to the jaw of Rene Catalan.
Pacio's in a good position right now to do a little bit of work with the ground and pound. You can see Catalan's got an overhook on the left side, just trying to control that posture. But like, it also kind of keeps him in that position. He's getting underhook and wants to swim out. So we never know what to expect when Catalan's on the ground. He might try to attack the leg again.
As Pacio try to draw Catalan to deep water, knowing that Catalan has never been in a 5-round match.
Pacio is 17 years younger than Catalan, so you have to imagine that in the 4th and 5th rounds, if it gets that far, the younger, more vibrant opponent is going to have the advantage. You can never count Catalan out, doing 40-year-olds all over the world proud.
Joshua Pacio has never lost here in Manila. His losses have all been on the road in Macau, Jakarta, and Yangon, Myanmar. Top position for the champion. Crossing elbow, rakes the top lip of Catalan. Catalan trying to control Pacio's posture. Posture's up now, drops a left and a right hand, and immediately Catalan pulls the neck down. Goes to the body, bang for right hand. Pacio looks to pass, goes there to side control. Dominance here from Pacio.
That was an easy pass, but Rene's giving him a von Flue choke. Good job to get back into half guard, but if he keeps that headlock like that, you can see Pacio can drive his shoulder into the neck of Rene Catalan. So Catalan actually Joshua should get his hand back into that position. Hit the head and drive his shoulder and try to choke him out.
Rene Catalan never wanted this match until Pacio came out in the media and said he could finish Catalan in under 15 minutes. He threw down the gauntlet, and now we've got it going in our main event. Look at the jump turning back kick, smack bang to the liver, and sent Catalan back 7 paces.
A Team Lakay specialty, they all use it to absolute perfection. There he is getting a very heavy takedown on Catalan. Was able to control it, but he gives up the leg, and then they start rolling. Picture me rolling, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, ready? 8-2, Rene Catalan. 14-3, Joshua Pacio. 8-3 in one championship, Pacio. 4-1 in his last 5. Let's see if he goes the wushu early on, Pacio. We know Catalan will. He fades that left hook for the champion.
Trade left hooks. Catalan was able to touch Pacio. Ooh, he starts spinning again. Look like he's found a home for that heel right on the tummy of Catalan. This is where Pacio is most dangerous. That head kick against Cerruto was a thing of beauty. This open range right here, Catalan can just pick and Pacio can just pick and choose his weapons.
You know the stand-up skill of Rene Catalan, a multiple world champion in wushu, but also the wrestling of Catalan.
Hey.
Puts hands on Pacio, picks him up and goes for the big boom shakalaka. He's got huge takedowns, but can he score one on Pacio? Looks for a single leg. Pacio sprawls out nicely, defends the takedown attempt.
Easily sprawls on the takedown there of Catalan. Catalan's legs seem a little bit wobbly, not fully underneath him at this point. I think something might be going wrong with the knee or the ankle. I don't know what's going on. Maybe it was that toe lock that Pacio had, but his legs seem a little bit unsteady in the standing position. Now Pacio's on top, working that half guard position.
Pacio's had a busy year. His third match of 2019. His busiest year since 2016, where he competed 6 times, going 5-1. Inside the half guard at the moment, top position for the champion in the ring.
Pacio might be trying to set up maybe an arm triangle, jumping to the other side. You can see how he's grinding his head upwards into that arm, so he's trying to lift the arm of Rene Catalan up, but he can't do it from this side. He's gonna have to jump to the other side if he wants to sink in this arm triangle, but it's kind of there for him. Now he's going into mount, the head is still there. If he can pass the other leg over, he might have an arm triangle.
And there's a time not long ago.
Yep, there it is. Let's see if he steps over. Now he's in full mount. Not quite set up correctly, but if he swings over to the other side, he can do it in full mount. Now he's got it locked in.
Now he's
got a bad spot.
Is this the time for Pacio to take the win? Catalan's in trouble. Catalan's in big trouble.
Pacio's got a good squeeze. He's got a good squeeze here.
The grimace on the face is about to tap out.
Got a wrap.
Is he about to tap out? He is. It's over. It's good night, Irene. Joshua Pacio retains the title. Joshua Pacio taps out. Rene Catalan.
That was beautiful. You saw the way he was setting it up. You could see what he was doing with his head position there. Once he got out of the half guard, got into full side control, stuck that head right up underneath the arm, transitioned into mount, completed the circle, locked in the squeeze, and forced the tap.
We said earlier, he was probably the best grappler in Team Lakay. He showed it again tonight, Joshua Pacio. The 23-year-old absolutely owning Rene Catalan for that submission win. I said earlier, there was a time not too long ago when Team Lakay held 4 of a possible 8 world championships in one championship. I still have one with Joshua Pacio. Of course, the other Filipino world champion in one championship is our heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera. And have a look at this again.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Pacio's got a tight squeeze. And once he had it locked in, it was academic. Beautiful, be done, gets another choke victory. You were saying he's got 3? I think he's got 4 now, Michael Cibello. Beautifully done for the passion, Joshua Pacio.
Let's go to Tom now, and the Dapper One will make it all official.
To present the belt for this match, please welcome the president of Grab Philippines, Mr. Brian Koo. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 29 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of arm triangle choke, and still one Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio.
Cutter Lawrence in big trouble. Is he about to tap out? He is. It's over. It's good night, Irene. Joshua Pacio retains the title.
Masasabi ko na na-defend ko. Champion na talaga ako.
The 23-year-old absolutely owning Rene Catalan for that submission win.
Napakasaya kasi sa age na to is sa age ko nagawa ko yun. Hindi yun yung end niya. Gusto ko pang i-defend to hanggat sa makakaya ko. Every fight, ibang Joshua Pacio.
There was a time not too long ago when Team Lakay held 4 of a possible 8 world championships in one championship.
Alam ko na may lalagpas pa sa taon na yun. Golden year yun kasi nga 1 year for belts. Pero para sa akin, if we see in every fight our improvements is umaangat, nagdo-dominate kami, I think dun na mag-i-start ulit yung golden year. Gaya ng sabi ko, walang pressure sa akin. Kung anong ini-expect ng tao. Basta para sa akin, para sa team ko, kung makikita kong nagle-level up ako bawat laban, I think sasama lahat yan. Kung magle-level up ako sa training at bawat laban, I can defend my belt and stay as a champion.
With the whole world watching on, he continues to improve out of sight.
As an athlete and as a champion, gusto kong ma-accomplish yung continuous na leveling up of my game. Yung bawat laban sana is iba eh. Iba yung game plan, iba yung style. Papanoorin mo yung laban ko last January, April, and November. Medyo may pagka-similarity. Pero yung gusto ko is yung continuous improvement na uy, iba yun ah. Iba si Joshua ngayon. Tapos iba na naman sa next. Yun yung gusto kong ma-accomplish.
Pacio laughed when he heard it. He said, well, you want to do it inside of 2? I'll do it inside of 1. And they go to ground inside the opening 17 seconds.
I asked Silva if he was going to pull guard. He said, I'm thinking about it. And he just did just that. Got the overhook, slid right into guard. Now he gets to work his magic off his back. Good job by Pacio to escape that. And let him back up.
Indeed. Pacio allows the former champion back to his feet. Bruce Simpson Wushu striking now from Pacio. Good counter right hand there from Alex Silva. Pacio with a polo punch.
Pacio is standing his ground. He's not too concerned with the way that Alex Silva's closing that distance into boxing range. Alex Silva's getting very close. He can touch you with the hands. He might be able to drop down and snatch up a single leg.
We know the improved striking on Silva, particularly with his leg kicks. We saw that against Naito, when he beat Naito with beautiful leg kicks. Step up knee there from Pacio. Open in orthodox stance. Thrusting jab from Pacio. Silva looks for a low single leg. Right hand there from Little Rock Alex Silva. Pacio looks calm and collected. The young 24-year-old champion. The 37-year-old former champion eats an uppercut off the right hand.
Look at the timing of Pacio. These are clean, crisp strikes that he's landing. Everything from the uppercut to the head kick that I'm sure is coming real soon. He is starting to figure out the distance and the speed of Alex Silva.
Silva momentarily switched to southpaw, now back to orthodox. Charges in, clinches up with Pacio. They do a tango. Backed up against the wall here, dropped down for a single leg to Silva.
This is what Silva has to do. He has to chain wrestle. He has to tack the single leg. If he doesn't get it, he's got to float into something else. But he is able to get this. It's not maybe the way that he wants to do it, but he is able to get this. this contest to the ground.
Is this advantageous for Silva and for Pacio?
Anything on the ground is advantageous for Alex Silva. He is a BJJ world champion who has very incredibly fast submission skills. You make one mistake, you leave one limb exposed, and he would try to take it back home to Singapore.
Mitch, is there a situation where you could see Pacio possibly submitting Silva?
I mean, anything is possible in this game, especially if Pacio starts launching into some of these big head kicks. If he can stumble Alex Silva and then jump on top of him, catch him and as he's discombobulated for a finish, I can see that happening. But in a straight grappling situation, probably not going to happen.
Nice jump turning back kick aim for the liver from Joshua Pacio, the young champion of the Philippines in the red, the challenger of Brazil in the white. 150 remaining, first round set for five. World Strawweight Championship on the line. Southpaw back to orthodox for Alex Silva. On the balls of his feet, Silva. High kick nicely done, roundhouse off the lead leg, no switch up from Pacio.
How composed Joshua Pacio is. Completely relaxed and calm, just waiting for his moment, picking his shots.
Not rushing, not overextending. He knows the wily veteran that is Alex Silva, and Silva knows all the tricks in the book. Silva even wrote some of the tricks in the book.
Silva competed at one championship, two. 2012, that's how long he's been in this game, man. He's got so much experience. This is his moment. He might not get another shot at the top of the mountain.
Southpaw stance again from Silva, now back to orthodox. Skip up outside, leg kick from the Brazilian. Runs Pacio to go to ground. Pacio says no. Amethyst to the foot of Silva. Quite ready to let the former champion up. Swings the legs a little. Olivia Goff may allow him to stand up in a moment. And up they get. A very big difference in style. The strike at Pacio, the grappler Silva. Now Silva top position. Could be stuck in the guillotine here. This may be Pacio's chance to sub Alex Silva. For Silva's sake. He's seen it all before. Top position now for the little one.
Silva needs to keep that pressure. He can't allow Joshua Pacio to have any little bit of space. He's just able to end this match on top. Nice little attempt to leg block there. He dives just as the last 10 seconds. I like the strategy coming from Alex Silva, but he's got to do a little bit more work. That's three attempts he's had at a finish at the bottom. He's been on the ground three times, but Joshua Pacio's confidence got to be at an all-time high. Look at this beautiful timing. This is what Alex Silva needs to be concerned with. It's these entries into the takedowns. Pacio is starting to figure out this timing. If he takes another step back, starts launching into uppercuts, and he starts to work the timing of that knee, here's a guillotine attempt by Alex Silva. Alex Silva was more concerned with passing the legs than protecting his neck. That can just goes to show you a little bit about the ground confidence coming from Alex Silva.
Now ready to roll, second round of five. The World Strawweight title on the line. Left of screen, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. Right of screen, the challenger, former world champion, Alex Silva. Inside Joshua. The sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Alex. Manila, the Philippines. A magnificent, glittering spectacle. Baldrick. Everyone in the corner of Pacio. And they touch gloves for round two. Very impressive opening stanza from the champion. Overhand right from Silva. High kick from Pacio. Silva locks up to a single leg. Pacio not going to ground. And now puts Silva on his back.
Look at the way Silva's trying, chasing those legs, cutting after a leg lock. Good job by Pacio to settle down, control the scramble. Now he's in guard. Let's see if Alex Silva starts to push down those legs. Alex Silva has an old school style of BJJ. He likes to pass the guard, get into side control, look for mounts, and then look for one of those arm bars.
Alex Silva, a 100% submission finishing rate. Every time he has finished an opponent, he's done so via submission. Now, don't forget, Silva said he would finish Pacio inside of 2 rounds. He's got 3 minutes 55 remaining to make it come true. He's stuck in an attempted guillotine choke, but he's out of it. Inside the closed out of Pacio. It was a very bold statement. Unlike anything we've ever heard from Silva. Usually doesn't make predictions, Alex Silva. Usually says what will be. Certainly made a statement. Would finish Pacio inside of 10 minutes.
Good job by Pacio, just to kind of control the overhooks, control the head posture of Silva, not letting Silva posture up and start dropping ground and pound, not allowing Silva to work his way past the full guard here of Joshua Pacio. Pacio still looks relaxed and comfortable. Silva's got to push down on that leg, try to work past it.
3 minutes, 5 remains. Silva still inside the guard of the Filipino. It's been a mixed bag for Team Lakay on our main card tonight. The win for Danny King, the loss for Edward Filiang. And now the only remaining world champion from Team Lakay, Joshua Pacio, trying to keep the gold in Baguio. Closes the guard again.
You can see the way Silva's trying to shove his head underneath the armpit. He's possibly looking for an arm triangle choke. He's got to get past the legs of Joshua Pacio. Nice little transition here. You can see how he sits up, controls the leg there. It's kind of a modified rubber guard, trying to control the posture of Joshua Pacio.
Feet on hips here from Silva. Now Pacio back to his feet. Silva circles off clockwise into the power side of Pacio. Got to watch the head kick. The one that spectacularly knocked out Saluta in what was declared the knockout of the year. That was in April of last year. The head kick that came in the fourth round against Saluta. And there it is, an attempt from Pacio. Top position here for Alex Silva Dragon.
Yeah, Silva's doing a good job of getting this match to where he wants, but he's not really doing anything with it once this gets to the ground. And Joshua Pacio's got good defense. They knew they were going to be in these kind of positions, so they drilled it over and over, making sure Pacio could maintain his guard and stay out of danger. And even when Silva does able, you know, to work his way past the guard, so he's trying to step over the legs into half guard. So he's trying to push that knee down a little bit. Pacio's doing a good job of staying out of danger. Nice job by Silva to float over. Now he's looking for a possible head and arm choke if he can get to the other side. He can actually finish it from this position right here. You can still apply that pressure with your shoulder and drive in. You don't have to be fully committed to the other side. You can choke from this position.
Silva now applies the pressure to Joshua Pacio. Can he take the championship belt back to Brazil? Alex Silva. Pacio defending.
Good work by Joshua Pacio to get out of that.
30 seconds remaining for Silva to find a finish inside of 2 rounds as he predicted. And Pacio survived. Silva keeps the Filipino on his back. Silva, who defended the title last time in an awful final affair against Rene Catalan, beat him in the second round by arm triangle choke. Thanks again. It looks like Pacio will get out of the second round. Now go into the third. Not where Silva thought he would be.
I like these entries in the leg locks that he's going for. He's slick. He's keeping Joshua Pacio thinking when he hits that ground by attacking those legs. Look at this arm triangle. This was deep. First, he had it in full mount. Joshua Pacio is tough as nails. This is deep right here. This is a black belt level squeeze, ladies and gentlemen. I want to see Joshua Pacio unload with those knees and uppercuts. As for Alex Silva, he's got to keep doing what he's doing. The more time that he spends on the mat, the more opportunities he has to catch that submission.
Third round of 5 for the Strawweight World Championship. In the red, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. In the white, the former champion. Tonight, the challenger, little rock Alex Silva. forget, folks, to follow us across all your social media platforms at ONE Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Let us know your thoughts so far. Outside of the kick from Pacio. Pacio, the master of inventive and explosive highlight reel finishes. Alex Silva, in the third round, thought he'd beat Pacio inside of two.
I can see Pacio fake that punch and then land a kick. You can see the way Silva's starting to cover up. He's fully shielding himself, and he's kind of blinded from the oncoming attacks. Pacio could land heavy body and leg kicks when he does that.
It has been a long time since we've seen Team Lakay without championship gold. If Pacio loses tonight, that will be the case.
Nice little knee as Alex Silva tried to close that distance. You do not want to allow Joshua Pacio to get comfortable in this range. Look at the jab.
Look up here from Pacio. These two men representing the two mega gyms in Asia. The Evolved MMA, Alex Silva, Team Lakay, Joshua Pacio.
Again, that's an unconventional way to get it to the ground. That's the third time that he's kind of pulled guard to get Joshua Pacio out down, but it works. Now he's got that butterfly hook on that side, so he's going to try to elevate it. Might be looking for the legs again. Good job by Pacio to work his way back up again.
Let's see if Pacio can affect some of the wushu striking now. Escapes from Pacio tonight, the improving escapes of all the Team Lakay combatants.
Man, you would think Harry Houdini is a coach over there at Team Lakay, because these guys vanish into thin air when you try to grab hold of them.
Simply, he's left here into the power side, the natural round kick of Joshua Pacio. Come off the right leg. Right downstairs with a jab from Pacio. Silva edging forward, wants to put hands on him, get a takedown, get Pacio possibly on his back.
I'd like to see more kicks coming from Silva. He has no fear of being taken down, so he might as well let go. Some fancy footwork.
Nice deep kicks again there from Pacio. Come on, seeing some leg kicks from Silva. We know he does have them in his arsenal. Highly improved strikes. Two punch combination from the Brazilian. Ball there from Pacio. Switches from a single to a double. Now up around the waist goes Alex Silva. 1 minute victory remains. Third round of five, Dragon.
Good job by Silva to work his way back up. You can see he went for the single, chain wrestled his way back into a body lock. He might look to pull guard again here. Pacio's takedown defense has been good, except for this pulling guard. That's one thing that's...
And only 24 years old, so many records already set by Pacio. Most title bouts in ONE Strawweight history. Most submissions in ONE Strawweight history. Second most wins in ONE Strawweight history. And second most finishes in ONE Strawweight history. 15-3 record, a massive 86% finishing rate, 8 subs, 5 knockouts. Beat Rene Catalan by arm triangle last time. To defend the title. First, that magnificent head kick knockout in the fourth round against Saruta. We know that Pacio can finish opponents in the deep water in the latter rounds. Close guard from the champion at the moment.
You gotta think the youth advantage that he's got, the 13 years younger that Pacio is, that's going to play his favor as the match goes on. But now they're starting to get slippery too, so it's going to be even harder for Silva to hold on to Pacio. So that's going to play into the favor of the explosive Team Lakay athlete, Joshua Pacio.
25 seconds remaining in what has been a thrilling contest so far. Nice and cool inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We hit about 32 degrees Celsius in Manila today. It's currently 25 degrees outside.
Yes, again.
Which sends some sweat starting to form on both these athletes. Jump to him, back kick aims towards the liver of Alex Silva. And there's trying to put the shin around the back of the neck. We go into the penultimate round. A very close contest.
Interesting third round, but a lot of work was done from Joshua Pacio standing. His knees are timed beautifully. The ways that he's able to figure out the distance, as you can see, Silva tries to get in tight, closing. But then Silva says, hey, I got knees of my own. Let me touch you on the chest, see how you like it. Good back and forth action, but the lead that Silva built up in that second round with all that top control, all that grappling dominance, might have started to bleed its way into the third, but Pacio looked good on the feet, landing significant strikes. I'd like to see a little bit more volume come out of Pacio this round. Silva, he's got to pressure forward. I'd like to see some leg kicks coming from Silva, but he's got to let those hands go.
It's the main event of ONE Championship Fire and Fury from inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. We're watching folks around the world, broadcast to over 140 countries, hopefully enjoying all the action. Don't forget, follow us on social media at ONE Championship on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. High kick there from Silva. Southpaw stance from the Brazilian. Round kick from Joshua Pacio. Switching stances, Silva. Dropped down, looking for a takedown, but Pacio in top position.
Beautiful little underhook push down right there from Joshua Pacio to maintain that top position. You know, in these fourth and fifth rounds, you have got to give a slight advantage to the conditioning of Joshua Pacio. These guys regularly run up mountains for their morning runs. Like, just the endurance that these guys are known for. They can push hard all five rounds.
They're always training at altitude, right? Mitch Baggio is up there in the hills.
Yes, it is.
What altitude is Baggio City at?
It's 11,000 feet.
Could be wrong. Put me up on Twitter.
And for a downward elbow, Pacio from inside the guard of Alex Silva. A little bit of damage under the right eye around the orbital of Silva. That was mostly incurred in the first round from the striking of Pacio. One foot on hips here from Alex Silva. Controlling the posture of the Filipino, the world champion in the red trunks. Which is consulting Google at the moment to find out the elevation of Baguio City. Just to clarify. Pacio, can he get the arms free here and drop some leather, some anvils on the face of Alex Silva? Silva trying to lift him. To no avail though for the former world champion. Butterfly guard now for Alex Silva. Of options available. Back to a foot on hips here for Silva.
You can see that Alex Silva's having a hard time getting a hold on Joshua Pacio because of the slipperiness, that this sweat after four rounds is starting to build up. But Alex Silva's constantly looking for different attacks. He's got so much mat time in his life. He's so dangerous, especially off his back. But that sweat, you can see Joshua Pacio was able to pull out because the legs are slippery now.
Crowd loving the chance that Pacio may be able to strike now. Genuflect position back onto his feet for Pacio. And the boss Olivia Cross says to Alex Silva, stand up. By the way, Mitch Baguio City, 5,000 feet above sea level. Jab two, another jab there from Pacio. Turns the knuckles in on the lead hook as Pacio. And Silva comes forward, knee to a right hand. High kick from Silva. They came close for the Brazilian. Body shot from Pacio. Silva edges forward, goes the outside thigh kick. Right bent trade jab. Left hand from Silva, didn't have the mustard behind it.
I gotta say that Joshua Pacio is putting a lot of the critics of Team Lakay to rest. There's been so much talk about the lack of ground game coming from Team Lakay, but he is showing a definitely elevated level of grappling. He's been able to stop all of Alex Silva's attacks on the ground. Look at it, piecing him up with that jab. Beautifully done on that straight right hand.
Oh, high kick was spinning back to the left hand. What a combination from Pacio. A beautiful combination. Now a double leg, and now a single leg from Silva. And Pacio defending. Silva wants the Filipino, the world champion, on his back.
Look at Alex Silva, he's trying to float over, but a good job by Pacio to maintain that guard. But look at that reversal. Joshua Pacio's on top. Alex Silva does a nice little hip escape to retain half guard.
This is a thrilling contest. This highly educated Philippines crowd enjoying the ground battle between Pacio and Silva.
You can see how Silva tries to go underneath that leg, trying to attempt deep half, looking for a submission. But Joshua Pacio, very well educated on the ground game, able to keep those heavy hips and prevent Silva from going anywhere.
Feet on hips from Silva. Trying to sub out Joshua Pacio. 20 seconds remains, fourth round of five.
Little elevator sweep there, beautifully done. Once he got that butterfly hook in, he was able to elevate Pacio over and reverse the position. Now he's pushed his leg down, end up in mount.
Once again, does he get the full note from Pacio, the champion, back to his feet. Final seconds, we are going into the deepest of deep water. We're going in for the fifth and final round.
The scrambling of Joshua Pacio is intense. Look at him, timing beautifully done, leans back, little hand exchange there as Pacio floats backwards. Beautiful little knee to a right hand, but then Silva throwing a head kick of his own. Pacio backs up and beautiful little shoulder roll from Alex Silva to avoid being decapitated by that head kick.
A little bit of Run DMC, tricky between rounds from our DJ here. And I'll tell you what, Joshua Pacio has been full of tricks in this title defense so far. 5 more minutes remaining. Can Silva get the title back, or will Joshua Pacio retain it? No one has left their seat inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. They're on the edge of their seats for this one. The final remaining Team of Guy world champion, Joshua Pacio, one of two Filipino world champions on the ONE Championship roster. The other being in attendance, the heavyweight world champion, Brandon Vera. And a roundhouse kick to the ribcage there from Pacio. Jumping knee! Jumping knee! And a takedown from Silva.
His timing on that knee is something spectacular. That was a jumping knee. It caught Silva flush, walked right through it, still able to get the takedown, put it down on the ground where he wants the match most. Now he's trying to work his way past the half guard. Good job by Pacio to retain full guard.
Explosive start from Joshua Pacio. Now top position for Alex Silva. Silva is so cunning, so wily, a veteran. As Mitch said earlier, he's been here since ONE Championship number two. 37-year-old former champion, 24-year-old current champion. And what a thrilling show they've put on so far. Closed guard here from Joshua Pacio.
You gotta wonder at this point, how did the judges see it? It's been so close. There's been a lot of top control coming from Alex Silva, but we're not seeing ground control. He's not really advancing his position in a lot of these ground grappling exchanges. He's not passing the guard. He's not working into mount. He's been held in one position. That's inside the guard of Pacio. But has Pacio been doing enough work on the feet to push that far ahead? It's been an interesting tactical strategy by both these athletes so far to see how things have played out in the first four rounds. And now we're approaching the fifth round. It could come down to this.
You know, on his ONE Championship debut back in 2012 at ONE Championship number two, Alex Silva was beaten by a member of Team Lakay in Jay, how you stuck we are.
See that Alex Silva has been attempting these, trying to pull guard, trying to drop down to his back. You know, you gotta wonder, are the escapes of Joshua Pacio, the way that he is defending, gonna weigh that heavily in the judges' eyes? In my mind, probably not, because they like to see them as faceless athletes, as, you know, not paying attention to anything of their skill set and just weighing what happens right in front of them.
2 minutes 25 remains, fifth and final round. Fake there from Silva. Thought about a sidekick, Wushu style did Pacio. Silva southpaw stance, edging forward the Brazilian now, switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Pacio thought about sliding with a jolt jab.
leads him with a hook instead. It is still anyone's for the taking. 120 seconds remaining. Leg kick there from Silva. Jump turning back kick. Hoping to find the liver of Alex Silva. The one that Kevin Bellion famously caught Andrew Leone with. It sent Leone across the ring some 15 paces. Single leg lock on here from Silva, hunting for a takedown. Hopscotch time for Joshua Pacio. Still can't get him down, now he does. Top position half guard for Alex Silva.
Nice single leg takedown for Silva. He's got 90 seconds to do work. He might be slightly behind in the judges' scorecards if you take in striking superiority into factor. And that's kind of the only thing that we're really seeing from Pacio. We're seeing a lot of top control. He has been able to land a couple of takedowns, but I don't know if pulling guard really counts as a takedown as well, because you're not controlling the opponent's hips. That single leg takedown was a takedown because he pulled him down, secured the hips, and was able to stay on top. But he's not showing any ground control. He's not passing the guard to Pacio, as Pacio gives a thumbs up to his fellow Colombians.
Thumbs up to the crowd for the confident young world champion, Joshua Pacio. What improvements Pacio has made over the last 18 months. Almost unrecognizable, especially with his ground game. Nice elbow there, and Pacio forced to quickly count his teeth. Looking for the ground and pound Silva. Postures up now, the Brazilian gets elevated by Pacio momentarily. 36-0, half guard position. They're screaming for Pacio. What has Silva got left with 20 seconds remaining? Can he get the right leg out? Can he pass guard, go to side control? No, he stays inside a half guard. Has he got a final squeeze? What's he got here, Alex Silva? Once again, we're going to go down with Joshua's in the middle. He was avoiding the left hand to Silva. Now switching to the right hand to the body. Get up to the hand, Alex.
Going to the judges' scorecards. The strawweight title tilt. In that fifth round, we saw a few takedowns coming from Alex Silva. He was able to lock in the body lock, stay nice and tight, get this match to where he wanted. But when he was able to get it there, was he doing enough in the eyes of the judges? Look at Joshua Pacio slowly backing up. Joes for the jumping knee, gives up the leg in the process, and that puts him in a position where he's able to get taken down. Another single leg takedown, but in that instance, was able to control the hips and get on top. But Pacio plays to the crowd, gives us a thumbs up. He's not really in a submission attempt. He's just kind of playing to the crowd and telling everybody that he's okay.
Okay, let's go to Tom Lau with our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have country marketing head of Grab Philippines, Mr. Ralph John Cabuna. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after 3 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision. And still, ONE Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio.
Championship gold stays in the Philippines. The reign of gold continues. Joshua Pacio.
Yes!
He answered many critics tonight.
Congratulations!
Especially on the ground against a 12 BJJ champion and a third degree BJJ black belt.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.